Very good morning, organizer, and very good morning, participants. This is a third day of our 5 days FTP in the title Deep Neural Networks and Expert System. As scheduled, today is the day that I am going to teach you the main theme of the FTP, that is Deep Neural Networks. Past 2 days, in the morning session, we listened about some theory that are treated as most fundamental and basic concepts to understand this deep neural network. In yesterday morning session, I have given you the title of the presentation as Shallow Neural Network. The first day presentation, I have given you a title, Basic or Primitive Neural Network Models. So those are all the historical developments in the artificial neural network, from primitive to shallow model, from shallow model to latest deep model. When you compare with the yesterday shallow neural network with this deep neural network model, the main difference is in terms of architecture. There, your architecture is shallow. It is just a word opposite to deep, right? And here, the architecture consists of depth in terms of number of layers. Hence, the title Deep Neural Network. Otherwise, the task and the operations are pertaining to architecture is changing, and the duty that is going to perform is pattern recognition. So I start with the overview of machine learning. In that, I told you that machine learning is very powerful in solving three different tasks: pattern recognition, decision making, and optimization. So the first task we are dealt with for the past 2 days and today also, pattern recognition task. And this pattern recognition task is solved by many different ANN model. And one latest advanced model that we are going to see today is deep neural network. Participants, the past 2 days, what I have delivered to you are the content that I used to deliver regularly in various FDPs and workshop, and those are all the experience either theoretically or practically that are my experience for the past 15 years. And I'm glad to say you that this is the first presentation, that is deep neural network is my first presentation to you, and I am also in the learning stage. And I hopefully deliver the content what you expect. And I assure that you will benefit from this presentation. And I want to make you to notify that in each slide, I am giving a source. Some URL is given. Maybe you have a PPT also. I have, on the morning before the session itself, I handed over the PowerPoint presentation to the organizer. If you have, you can note it down the URL. Or later you can note it down the URL. So each slide is going to be a concept that you have to study in depth separately after this FDP. So here, what I'm going to teach you is an overview of these deep neural network model. So I treat this session as an eye-opening session or an entry session into the deep neural network model. So let me start the session. So first of all, I wish to give you the difference between the shallow neural network and the deep neural network in terms of architecture. Look at the diagram in the left side. See the year 1980s era, that is neural network. At that time, it was given neural network. Since at present, the deep neural network has gained momentum, this 1980s era's neural network can be called as shallow neural network. Why? Because because of the presence of single hidden layer between the input layer and the output layer. Remember, participant, in this particular layer, the input layer nodes doesn't have any computational task. It just passes the information. Whereas the node in each hidden layer, as well as the node in each output layer, are treated as a neuron. That is, it treated as a soma of a biological neuron, and its duty is to do two tasks, summation and activation. In shallow neural network, the hidden layer, the neurons of the hidden layer does this duty, and the output is passed to the next layer. There also similar duty is performed and output is produced. Here in this model also, you can increase the number of hidden layers. That means in shallow neural network also, you can increase the number of hidden layers. Then why it is called as shallow? Even though you increase the number of hidden layers, the operation carried out by each neuron in the hidden layer are the same operation, that is activation and summation operation. Summation and activation operation. So when you increase the number of hidden layer in the traditional neural network, that is shallow neural network, even though the architecture looks like a depth, it is called by the name multi-layer perceptron. Again, it is the duty of the perceptron. See, biological, the concept is called a neuron, whereas in artificial, the single processing element is called perceptron. So again, it is the multi-layer perceptron only, even though if you introduce more layer. And each layer neuron is doing the similar task of summation and activation. So this part of network is doing a same task over the layers to produce the output. Coming to the present day model, that is the latest and a more advanced model, which is widely studied by many people across the world, that is deep learning neural network. Look at the architecture. There are many layers between input and output. For simplicity, here it is shown three layers. And look at the operations of each and every layer. See here, the input layer itself is doing some task. Whereas when we go back to our shallow neural network model, the input layer doesn't do any activity, just it passes the information. Whereas when you look into the picture of this deep neural network model, see the input layer is doing some kind of activity. What is the activity? That is identification of the pixel value, whether it is light pixel or dark pixel. It is for some kind of example for this kind of problem, identifying this input image. Then it identifies the edge in the first hidden layer, and in the second hidden layer, some kind of combination of edges are identified. In the third hidden layer, features are identified. And finally, combinations of identified features are used to produce the output. So there are many hidden layers are present, and each hidden layer process the features, and those features are treated as hierarchical features. That is, from simpler form of features, it is processing to a complex form. So participant, the major difference between these two models, shallow and deep model, is presence of not only many layers, but the operation defined on each layer is also varying when compared with the shallow network model. Each and every layer in the deep neural network and each and every neuron in the deep neural network is doing its own operation intended for the purpose of the task. And also, you should remember one more point here. The shallow neural network is widely used for the data that is of in the form tabular structure. That is mostly a numerical structure. But this deep neural network is always accepts input that is of the form either image or audio video file. Here you have one question. What is the question is, yesterday morning session when I closed the presentation, I have given you a small case study with respect to how to develop the model, intrusion detection, web page classification, and finally I have given you a a case study about face recognition in single slide with the variety of faces and how to do the face recognition with shallow neural network with a glimpse of idea in that single slide itself. So what is the sense there? It's if you want to do face recognition using the shallow neural network, you should do all the feature extraction task or all the pre-processing task or all the preliminary task. Then you need to convert each image of a person as a vector. Then that vector only fed into the model. Although you need to provide more number of training images for such a shallow neural network, and your shallow neural network is not fast and competitive enough to understand the data pattern, and it is very slower in nature to produce the output. Of course, I face this difficulty when I am working with my colleague during my master program while developing the shallow neural network model for a simple facial recognition problem. So, but this deep neural network, the specialty of this deep neural network is to accept the image and produces the corresponding output, or accepts the audio or video file and produces the corresponding output. Let me explain this scenario with one more slide with the help of the task pattern recognition. So when you do the task pattern recognition, it can be done either with the help of shallow neural network or with the help of deep neural network. Let me give an example of an input image. See, the input image is an image which has some cat. So now if I want to introduce input this image into a neural network model to say what the output of the image is. If I use shallow neural network model, then I should have a separate facility for conducting the feature extraction task. And after extracting the features, the image is represented as a vector, then it is fed into the shallow neural network model for identification, or otherwise it is called by the name classification, into kitten, puppy, or something else. But when you take the deep neural network model, the same input is applied, but what is done here? The feature extraction as well as the classification task are carried out in the same neural network model rather than doing it separately in case of shallow neural network model. So this is the way in which the recognition task can be studied with the help of shallow model as well as the deep model. So participant, I hope you follow the lecture, and you note down that in each slide I have given a source, and this source can be used by you after this FDP, or whenever you want to study depth into the architecture, you can explore further into the material. Next, see a simple scenario of recognizing a face using deep neural network. Look at the picture here, input layer, hidden layer 1 and hidden layer 2. Look at the input layer, again the input layer is divided into so many layers. Look at the hidden layer, again it is divided into so many layers. Look at the hidden layer 2, it is divided. So what I am trying to convey is the number of layers is enormous, and it can be introduced one by one until we expect the desired accuracy, or until our goal of identification of the pattern or identification of the audio or video or image is achieved. So look at this picture. So first, in the input layer, what it does, some patterns of local, that is some local patterns have been extracted. In the second layer, facial features are extracted. In the third layer, the face resemblances are identified, and finally the faces are classified. So whenever you thought of using these deep neural network model, the architecture is itself complex and consisting of many layers, and each layer is doing some kind of activity to produce the final expected desired output. Now let me discuss about the key concepts of the neural network model. This deep neural network model, in what way it is differentiated from the shallow neural network model? I can say that a shallow neural network model is a single hidden layer model, whereas a deep neural network model is a multiple hidden layer model. So the major difference between deep neural network model as well as with the shallow neural network model is depth. In doing so, when we give an input to the deep neural network model, the input passed through many layers and it is treated as a multi-step process. Instead of one step process in case of shallow neural network model, the recognition task is treated as a multi-step process to produce the output. And you should remember that, and that each layer of the node is being trained with some different set of features based on the output of the previous layer. That is, one layer output is fed as the input to the another layer. That means in one layer, some set of features are processed, that is given as input to another layer. There some set of input features are processed, then it is given to neighboring layer. So likewise, the processing is going on as a multi-step process. So what a deep neural network does, it finds a relationship among the data from simpler to complex form. So what the hidden layer might be doing, that is, it is first identifying some kind of simple operations. That means by means of identifying the edges of an image or borders or whatever it is treated in terms of the image that you are given, followed by it will learn more complex things. Say, for example, let me take the face recognition. If you give image as an input, the first set of layer understand the features related with edges, followed by facial parts, then faces, and finally desired face. Likewise, if you want to develop audio recognition system, the first level of the layer will identify some lower level features, then followed by phonemes, followed by words, and then sentences. So this is the idea, or I can say that key concept behind the operation of a deep neural network. Now, shall we define what is deep learning? So deep learning is not a new one. It is the subfield of machine learning, and it is concerned with algorithms inspired by the structure and the function of the human brain. And it is treated as a model under the umbrella of artificial neural network. But what is the specialty of this model? The specialty of the model is many layered structure. And of course, it is also trained with the help of back propagation algorithm. And there are three popular techniques under the concept of deep learning with respect to architecture. One is multi-layer perceptron and convolutional neural network. And the third one is recurrent neural network. I already said that multi-layer perceptron is not going to use exactly the idea of deep learning, even though it is treated as having many hidden layers. The operations are very simpler when I said earlier in the initial title slide. So each neuron is intended to do the same operation of activation and summation. But this convolutional neural network and the recurrent neural network, the neuron in each layer is intended for its own duty, that is defined throughout the development of the model. So deep learning model excels on problem domains with the input data. So you remember, if the input data is in the form of tabular form, that is a normal numerical data or a normal benchmark data that we have discussed in the yesterday class, like iris flower data or the so many data, maybe any disease data. If it is in the tabular form, that is, simply speaking, if it is a structured data, then the previous model that we have learned first day and the second day of the FDP is useful. Suppose if your data is of unstructured data or something called as big data in the form of images or in the form of documents or in the form of files with respect to audio or video, then one can go for deep learning. Participants, you hope you follow the idea of deep learning. So first, let me teach the first deep learning neural network model, that is convolutional neural network model. So convolutional neural network model is shortly called by the name CNN or ConvNet. So what is, how it is defined? It is nothing but a class of deep feedforward artificial neural network applied to visual imagery. What it means, the input for convolutional neural network is always an image. whenever you go an image or some collection of images, and if you want to do some recognition task, that is identification of image with respect to each image, then surely you have to go for using the convolutional neural network model. So the input for CNN is always an image. That means the deep learning algorithm in the CNN model accepts the image and tries to find the weights and bias in order to differentiate the images from one another to finally produce the output, for which the convolutional neural network is having many layers. All these layers are treated into three different categories. One is convolutional layer, second one is pooling layer, and the third one is fully connected layer. This is the basic architecture of CNN. If you look at the CNN architecture, when an input image is given, the first task that you are going to do is convolutional operation, followed by pooling operation. Then these two operations can be alternatively given until we expect the desired accuracy. So you can either increase the number of convolution and you can increase the number of pooling operation to any number. Finally, that is before producing the output, you should have a layer, and that layer is called fully connected layer. Once the fully connected layer have done its intended duty, then the output is produced by the final output nodes. Look at the operations. There are four main operations performed by the ConvNet, that is standard convolutional neural network model. Convolutional operation, then is followed by activation operation with the help of a activation unit, ReLU, that is a rectified linear unit, that is an activation operation. Then it is operation called pooling operation, or otherwise called by the name sampling operation. Then finally classification operation by the fully connected layer. So when an image is passed, then it is passed through a series of convolutional layers. Each layer is doing a kind of task called filtering or identification of the future maps with the help of kernels, followed by some kind of dimensionality reduction has been carried out with the help of pooling. Then finally, classification is conducted in the fully connected layer, over which softmax function is applied to identify the object. If you look at this picture, see the final layer. Final layer produces the possible output for the input image. What are the possible output? It may be a dog, it may be a cat, it may be a deer, it may be a lion. Within bracket, there are some values given. These values are probabilistic value. So the probabilistic value for cat, dog is 0.1, 0.4, deer is 0.94, and lion is 0.2. What it means, when you given this input image may be treated as a dog with a probability of 0.1. This input image may be treated as a image of cat with a probability 0.4, with the deer with a probability 0.94, and lion with a probability 0.2. Of course, you know answer now. Which is having the maximum probability is the final output. So the output is produced in the output layer like this form, that is with the probabilistic value for different categories, over which softmax function is applied to produce the final output. It is nothing but application of some simple threshold value of 0.5. In yesterday program also, I said that small y is produced when you use the sim command. That small y is nothing but actual output. If you look exactly the value produced by the actual output, those values are probabilistic value. Then if you look at the program, after that, I find an error E with respect to Y to N and Y, followed by there occurs a small logic with the help of if else statement. That is, I use a threshold value of 0.5. If the probabilistic value is more than 0.5, 1 is produced. If it is less than 0.5, 0 is produced. Then only actual output Y2, which is contained 100 or 010 or 001 with respect to three different categories of flower, can be treated exactly to the corresponding network output. So same idea here, that is, with the help of softmax function, the probabilistic values are converted into 0 and 1 to identify the correct pattern of the given input image. Let me explain the operation one by one. First, let me take the convolution operation. So you always assume that the input given to the CNN is an image. So imagine an image which is read as a 5x5 matrix. So these are all the pixel values associated with the image. Before doing a convolution operation, you should decide upon the kernel. So you should depend upon the stride value and you should know what is padding. So everything and all I will discuss about in that in the afternoon practical session. So imagine a stride of 3x3 size. Now this stride is used to the given input image and the convolution operation is performed. So what is mean by this convolution operation? Just placing this kernel over the matrix of the input image and do the calculation to produce the 3x3 matrix like this. What is the first element of this 3x3 matrix? It is nothing but the operation that is given here. See, I am placing this matrix over here. That means 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 2 into 0 or 0 into 2 plus 2 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus. Likewise, the operation is conducted and the final value we got is 13 and 13 is stored here. Now, how to fill the second value? This stride is moved to the next. That is, now the stride is placed over the first column. Now the stride is moved to the second column. Third, if you want to produce a third value, then it is moved to third column. So likewise, the kernel matrix is moved over the image matrix. And for every movement, the value, convolutional operation value is calculated like this. And then the output is produced like this. So like this kind of operation is carried out over the stack of convolution layers. So if you imagine a stack layer, so you imagine a convolution layer, it is not a single layer or it is not a single matrix. It is present in the form of stack of convolution. For each stack, you have to perform this operation. And then followed by the convolution operation, you have an operation called ReLU. So what is ReLU? ReLU is rectified linear unit. It is nothing but an activation function. So what are the activation function we learned so far in the previous days FDPs? Tan sigmoidal function, binary sigmoidal function, step function, linear function. So likewise, we learned so many activation function. Like that of the activation function, ReLU is one activation function. In general, what is the activity of an activation function? You know that once a neuron does the summation operation, over the summation operation, some kind of activation is applied to produce the output. Once you calculate the net input by means of summation operation, from the net input, output is calculated by applying the activation function. Same thing here. So net input is calculated, some kind of matrix is calculated. That is, image of 5x5 matrix is reduced to a future map matrix of 3x3 by applying a kernel of 3x3 with the help of convolution operation. Then this 3x3 matrix is fed into the ReLU unit, and the ReLU unit will do its activity based on the operation defined in it. So what is the operation defined in the ReLU unit? So ReLU is a piecewise linear function that will accept a matrix and look into the value of each matrix. If the value of the matrix is positive, then it just passes that value. If any of the pixel value is found to be negative, then it will simply put the value 0. So what it does is, a matrix containing pixel values, if it is positive value, it means that this pixel value is having some kind of knowledge in it. If it is negative value, then it doesn't have enough knowledge so that it can be eliminated or it can be removed. So for that operation, it is ReLU unit is used. Look at the operation here. A matrix is given. Look at the matrix. Some kind of values are associated. Each value is a pixel value. Look at it. The first one is 15. Second one is 20. Third one is -10. So likewise, all the data pixel elements values are shown here. So if you apply this transfer function, that is activation function,